Dit is Papa Alpha 0 Echo Tango Echo voor de Daily Minutes met een nieuwsupdate voor vandaag 2 januari 2016. Dit is het bulletin van zaterdag. Ja, ik moet een beetje lachen, want ik had het bulletin al ingesproken, maar ik moet 2 keer op de opnameknop drukken. De eerste keer dan is het om in te stellen en de tweede keer is om het op te nemen. Nou, die tweede keer had ik eigenlijk niet goed genoeg doorgedrukt, want er was niets gebeurd. In het weekend zijn de Daily Minutes in het Engels. We hebben Contestia vandaag met de gebruikelijke instellingen en ook een plaatje in SSTV BW12. Welcome to the English Weekend Bulletin of the Daily Minutes. No propagation bulletin was issued. Apparently, because of the holidays, there will be no remarkable propagation. And my knowledge of all propagation forms and prediction isn't far-fetched enough to be able to issue my own propagation bulletin. The only 2 podcasts, except for the PA00 news bulletin that came out on New Year's Day, are the Amateur Radio Newsline and the news bulletin of VK1WIA in Australia. So today we will bring you several of the topics of the Amateur Radio Newsline. We do have Contestia today with the usual properties, and we will also have an SSTV picture in BW12 at the end of the bulletin.
Amateur Radio Newsline Report number 1992 with a release date of Friday, January 1st, 2016. The following is a QST.
Now reporting from Picayune, Mississippi, here is Don Wilbanks, AE5DW.
We begin the first newscast of 2016 with our wishes for a Happy New Year and with some ways to get yourself in shape for the busy year ahead on the air. In fact, think of the first few days of 2016 as a good workout for all those radio-intensive months to come. During the first days of the new year, you can even give your microphone a break. The ARRL's annual Straight Key Night launches the contest calendar on New Year's Day, Friday, January 1st, and it's not really competitive, as there are no points, except for the most important point of all, which is to have fun. And before you start thinking that the weekend's radio events are just for adults, think again. The younger set gets in on the action Sunday, January 3rd, during the ARRL's Kids Day. Hams are being encouraged to open their shacks to younger family members, the local scout troop, neighborhood youngsters, anyone really, who has a youthful curiosity about what it's like to hit that push-to-talk button or tap a code key. Visit the ARRL website to see operating recommendations and, of course, what the event exchange will be. A word of caution, be sure you know your favorite color before you get on the air. That information is a vital part of the exchange. This event will be repeated in June, but why wait? The year is young, and so are all those potential hams waiting out there. In Wisconsin, a bit of hospital equipment has just become ham equipment, too. Recognizing the important role amateur signals can play in local disasters, Ministry Eagle River Memorial Hospital has given space on its tower to a local club repeater. The Vilas County Amateur Radio Club, KD9DXK, has activated its repeater, making it ready for service in emergencies or to assist with community events. Mark Descalos, a spokesman for the hospital, told National Public Radio member station WXPR recently that bringing the ham radio club onto the tower was a decision that made good sense. Descalos said, quote, "Here in the Northwoods, we have difficulty with cell signals and probably equal wise with radio signals. It was an opportunity to use our tall antenna at the hospital to install a repeater," end quote. Club members will make use of the expanded signal to provide communication support for community events as well as community disasters. The tower space is being provided free to the club. Anyone who appreciates what older radio equipment can still do will appreciate the importance of a commemorative moon bounce event taking place this month in New Jersey. Amateur Radio Newsline's Heather Emby, KB3TZD, tells us the plan.
70 years ago, a team from the U.S. Army operating at Fort Monmouth, New Jersey's Project Diana site successfully copied radio signals that had been bounced from the moon using an Army tracking dish. That site is now part of the Info Age Science History Museum, where on January 10th, the EME, or Earth-Moon-Earth bounce, will be recreated, marking the date when the historic transmission both left its mark and its signal in 1946. In fact, the radio amateurs intend to use that same dish, which has long since been demilitarized and refurbished. The TLM-18 received those first historic signals during its time of active service on that site as a ground station for the Tyros 1 and 2 weather satellites and for Project Vanguard. The commemorative transmission will occur on 23 centimeters from the station of the Ocean Monmouth Amateur Radio Club, N2MO, sent by members of that club as well as hams from Princeton University and the Science Museum. The dish's primary role, as used by Daniel Marlowe, K2QM, is to help observe radio pulsars as well as radiation from the Milky Way. Marlowe teaches physics at Princeton University and serves on the board of InfoAge. The TLM-18 is being made available for the amateur's moon bounce on a secondary basis. Nevertheless, promising this group the moon and then delivering is going to be just as historic an event as it had been back in 1946. For Amateur Radio Newsline, I'm Heather Emby, KB3TZD in Berwick, Pennsylvania.
Thank you, Heather. Giving a boost to student and teacher literacy in wireless technology, the ARRL has selected 7 schools to receive grants from its Education and Technology Program for the academic year 2015-2016. The schools are Akron STEM High School, Akron, Ohio, Liberal Arts and Science Academy High School, Austin, Texas, Life Christian School, Aloha, Oregon, Rock Canyon High School, Highland Ranch, Colorado, Southport Elementary School, Kenosha, Wisconsin, Wink High School, Wink, Texas, and Yucaipa High School, Yucaipa, California. The application deadline for these grants, which are given annually, is November 1st. The grants encourage the use of amateur radio to explore radio science and electronics and focus on lessons in math, science, engineering, and technology through hands-on activities. So far, 579 schools have received support from the ARRL program, which comes in the form of research grants or equipment. 2 special events that had been set for late 2015 are being rescheduled following their cancellations. The popular Iron Ham Contest, which was to have marked its 4th year, was dropped from the calendar after organizers noted how congested the bands already were with various competitions at year's end. The worldwide 3-mode contest, inspired by the Sporting World event of the same name, is a 24-hour 3-mode contest that has amateurs operating on SSB, CW, and RTTY. Adelano Ohms, PY5EG, one of the Brazilian amateurs involved in the organizing, said the 2016 contest would be announced at a later date. And Eris canceled its late December slow scan TV event aboard the International Space Station. The move was the result of what organizers called complications in planning. The good news is that the wait won't be quite as long for this event. Eris has said it is looking to reschedule the slow scan for mid-January 2016.